In your experience in the fast-moving world of retail, is innovation always about creating something new, about starting from scratch, or is it also about adapting to sudden changes?
One always talks about innovation in the context of a product or in the context of any technology. The reality is that the only way in retail you can ever maintain leadership is by innovating.
There's also been a certain innovation, I think, in the branding of Raymond, especially with the TV ads that we've seen recently of the Raymond man having sort of an overhaul in the image, where from the quiet, silent type, he's become more of a friendly, outgoing type.
While Raymond occupies a very strong positioning of the complete man, which is a kind of a timeless concept, it's also important that we do things which will make the next generation relate to that same image. So our challenge today as a brand is how do we retain our existing loyal customers and at the same time open ourselves up for the young generation and make them feel that it is a brand for them also.
Is that difficult to do, especially in a market where every segment has so many flashy international brands entering and flooding the market?
The paradox that we have to kind of handle within the Raymond shop is we are selling fabric, we offer tailoring services, and we also have our apparel. So how do you ensure that within a store, a customer has the choice of picking up any of these options? Now, it's always been believed that the kind of people who go for tailoring are different from the kind of people who prefer ready-to-wear. And here we have a format within which both are available. Now, how do you manage these paradoxes and at the same time ensure that you maximize the sale of fabric and also ensure that the customer who's walked in for apparel also has enough choice? That's about the Raymond shop and within the Raymond shop. The real competition is how, as a format, I compete with top-of-the-line apparel brands, okay? So you walk into any mall today and you will see that an apparel brand store looks different. A Raymond shop, because of the nature of the products and services that it offers, has certain limitations. Within that, how do I still attract footfalls? So on a product-to-product basis, yeah, our products are as good and some of them are in fact even better than what some of the leading apparel brands are. But they sit inside the Raymond shop. But when it's in a mall and you tend to attract anyone who's just walking past, how do I make the store look attractive enough when I'm sitting absolutely next to some of the leading Indian brands and also some of the international ones which have just started coming?
Innovative measure taken by Raymond, which was discussed a lot, was the made-to-measure buses that were sent out. Is that something that was an experimental thing that Raymond did, or is that something you're doing?
There was a lot of talk about, what is retailing? Is it that you open a store, wait for a customer to walk in? You know, 2 years back, we did an ad for the Raymond shop which said, come and see. Okay, so our mindset itself was, I have opened a grand store, I have put the best of products, I am ready to give you the best service, please come and see. And we had to change that entire orientation and say, can we afford to wait for the customer to come to the store? So while Raymond couldn't go from, a high street store or brand to a e-retailing kind of a model, we said, what's the other way that we can actually reach out to our customer? And that's how was born the idea of a mobile bus. Where suddenly, there isn't a product, there are just swatches. And you're actually co-creating something with the customer. And it's not something that a typical Indian customer is also used to. Yeah, he's used to picking up something off the shelf which is already seen. And we've used it as a promotion tool. So we've taken it to various campuses. Last 15 days it was in the Infosys campus in Bangalore. We've taken it to some of the management institutes. We've taken it to some of the clubs in Bombay. And we realized that though we had thought of it just as a basic promotion tool for the concept, people actually get so comfortable with the way it's done that they actually place orders within the bus itself. Yeah, so we have now started setting targets for it. See, there was a phase in all products where you went to a complete, mass production. Then there came a time when you started doing a kind of a customization. Today you've come to a stage where you're doing mass customization. So you have laptops. But with the laptops, you have, you know, different finishes, so you can personalize it. So we were looking at not so much the e-retailing part of it, but we were looking at this trend of personalization.
You had over 2 decades of experience in talent acquisition, talent management. For the benefit of the students of Center for Management, what are in general the attitudes and skills and the values that you look for in employees that you hire?
Within the Raymond Group itself, there's denim, shirting, textiles, suiting, shirting, there's FMCG and all of that. Now, what are the values that bind all the people together? They are the same values that we have attached to the brand, which is trust, leadership, excellence. The kind of environment that we've been trying to create is where you've got to carry the traditional part of the business along with the newer parts of the business. So if you come to the campus in Thana, you'll suddenly find that there are people who are there in the legacy businesses, and you also have a whole lot of young designers and retailers, you know, on the campus. So we had to create a situation where both of them can gel with each other. So it took us some time, but I think today there is a situation where anyone coming in new feels very, very comfortable, because there is still this caring part of the culture. And at the same time, since, you know, the world is really ruthless and it's not going to make any concessions for you just because you have been a great brand, we had also to bring in a very, very strong performance orientation. So anyone who wants to be a part of Raymond has to be someone who's concerned with what value he or she is adding.